Hello everyone, today we are going to see our next point, that is substitution method. Okay, already you have seen algebraic methods, graphically method you have seen. Okay, so here what is given, see algebraic solutions of system of linear equation, algebraic solutions of system of linear equation. In that, method of elimination by substitution, method of elimination of equity by equity coefficients, and method of cross multiplication. Okay, there are three methods. Already you have seen graphical method, but sometimes graphical method does not give us accurate answer. Okay, so we need to use some precise method. Okay, so there are three methods which will give you accurate answers. Understood? And the graphical method is a little bit time consuming. Understood? So here this is algebraical method, and three methods are there. Okay, so according to the instruction we need to use this. Okay, so already we have seen this substitution method, already we have seen in class 9. Okay, so you will understand immediately. Then method of elimination by equating the coefficient, that also we have seen. Understood? So these two methods already we have seen little bit. And third one, method of cross multiplication. This method is depend on a formula. Okay, so that also we are going to see. Now we are going to see about method of elimination by substitution. Okay, from name only you can understand there we need to do substitution. Okay, so here I have taken algorithm for the substitution method. So what is first? Express y in terms of x in one of the given equation. Second one, substitute the value of y in other equation. Third one, solve the linear equation in x obtained in step 2, and solve the above linear equation in y to get the value of y. Okay, these are four steps, algorithm, how to solve by example by substitution method. Here it is given, four steps are given. Now I have taken here one example. There are two simultaneous linear equations in two variables, that is first one 2x minus 3y is equal to 7, x plus y is equal to 1. Okay, there are two equations, so this is, I am saying, first one equation, this is second equation. Okay, we have to use here substitution method to find out value of x and y. Okay, so now we are going to use here substitution method. So any one equation we can use for the substitution. Okay, so here see, 2x minus 3y is equal to 7 and x plus y is equal to 1. So this second one I am going to use for the substitution. Okay, so any one example you can use this or this. So here this I am taking x plus y is equal to 1. Okay, here what is first step? They have told us express y in terms of x in one of the given equations. Express y. Okay, it is not like that only we can express y, we can express x also in terms of y. Any of we can. So here y is equal to what is going to come? 1 minus x. Y is equal to 1 minus x from this equation. Okay. So here we can write in solution by using second equation for substitution. Okay. Second equation we have taken here x plus y is equal to 1. So y is equal to 1 minus x. Okay. So now put y is equal to 1 minus x in equation first, because second equation we have taken for the substitution. So this substitution, this value of y we will put in the equation 1. So what is equation 1? 2x minus 3y is equal to 7, that is equation 1. So now y is equal to 1 minus x, at the place of y we will put 1 minus x. So 2x minus 3 will remain as it is. What is the value of y? 1 minus x. So here we will put 1 minus x is equal to 7. Okay, so now if you solve this, then what will be 2x minus 3 into 1 minus 3 minus 3 into minus x, it will be plus 3x is equal to 7. Okay, so 2x plus 3x will be 5x. 2x plus 3x, 5x is equal to 7. This minus 3 we will move that side, that will be plus 3. Okay, so x is equal to what is going to get? 7 plus 3 is 10 divided by 5. This 5 we will take here, and there will be division. So 10 divided by 5 is 2. So we want the value of x is 2. Okay. See here once again what we have done. We have taken second equation for the substitution. X plus y is equal to 1. So y is equal to 1 minus x. So put this value in the equation first, that is 2x minus 3y is equal to 7. At the place of 1, we need to put the value of y, 1 minus x. So that we have taken after solving, we got here equation in one variable, linear equation in one variable. Okay, in terms of x, we have taken the value. So here we got equation in one variable. So what is the answer? 2x plus 3 is 5x, 7 plus 3 is 10, so x is equal to 2. Okay, now we have the value of x, so we can put in any one equation, you will get y. Okay, so put by putting x is equal to 2 in equation second. Okay, in equation second or in equation first, you will get the same answer. So x plus y, equation second is x plus y is equal to 1. Value of x is 2. Okay, so that we can put here 2 plus y is equal to 1. So y is equal to 1 minus 2. So y is equal to 1 minus 2 is minus. So value of x is 2 and value of y is minus 1. Okay, so we have here both the values. This is known as substitution method because we have substituted here value of y in terms of x. Okay, so this is substitution method. So one example we have seen, some more examples we will see. Okay, see here we are going to see some more examples. From that second one example is s minus t is equal to 3 and s by 3 plus t by 2 is equal to 6. Okay, so two simultaneous equations are given, first and second. This is first equation, this is second equation. Okay, we are using here substitution. Now any one equation we can use for the substitution. Okay, so this is this s minus t is equal to 3. That value we can put easily. So that I am using. Okay. So in solution s minus t is equal to 3. This is first equation. So s is equal to 3 plus t. Okay. S is equal to 3 plus t. So by putting, so put s is equal to 3 plus t in equation. Now which equation you will use? Equation second. Okay. In equation second. So equation second I am taking as it is s by 3 plus t by 2 is equal to 6. Okay, so at the place of s we need to put 3 plus t. So after putting this value we will get linear equation in one variable. Okay, so s is equal to 3 plus t divided by 3 plus t by 2 is equal to 6. Okay, now here what we can do, we need to make denominator same. Okay, so what we can do, we can multiply by this 2 here, that is 2 in bracket 3 plus t plus 3 into t, 3t, and the product of the denominator is 3 2s are 6, so that is going to remain 6 as it is here also 6. Okay, now you will solve further, then you will get 3 2s are 6 plus 2t plus 3t is equal to 6 into 6, 6 into 6 is 36. Okay, so what you will get finally, 6 3t plus 2t, 5t is equal to 36 minus 6. This plus 6 will move that side, that will be subtraction. 36 minus 6. So 3t plus 2t, 5t, 36 minus 6. So 5t is equal to 36 minus 6 will be 30. So t is equal to 5, 6 are 30. T is equal to 6. Understood? So now this is the value of t. Okay, now we need to find out s. So s we have, s is equal to 3 plus t. Okay, suppose you want here, you can say this is third equation. Okay, so put t is equal to 6 in equation third. Okay, t is equal to 6, we can put in equation third. So s is equal to, what is third equation? S is equal to 3 plus t. So 3 plus, value of t is 6. So 3 plus 6 is 9. So s is equal to 9. So we have both the values, t is equal to 6 and s is equal to 9. We can cross check our answer. See, if you put here 9 minus 6, 9 minus 6 is 3. So any one equation we can use for the verification. Okay, so we have seen second example by substitution. Okay, now one more example we have here, that is third one example. So here this is I'm saying first and this is second equation. So what is first equation? Root 2x plus root 3y is equal to 0. And second one is root 3x is equal to minus root 8y is equal to 0. Okay, so any one example we can use for the substitution. I am taking this second one example, root second one equation, root 3x minus root 8y is equal to 0. This is second equation is given. So we can write here this root 3x is equal to root 8y. Okay, minus root 8y is 0 plus this will be root 8y. Okay, so we can write here x is equal to root 8 upon root 3y. X is equal to root 8 upon root 3 into 1. Okay, root 3 we have taken this side, so there will be division, root 8 divided by root 3 is equal to into 1. Okay, so this value of x now we will put in the equation first. Okay, so put x is equal to root 8 upon root 3 into 1 in equation first. Okay, root 8 we can factorize. Root 8 we can write 4 to the 8. Okay, so 8 we can write 4 to the 8. So 2 root 2, the value of root 8 will be 2 root 2. So that also we can write. Okay, so now I am taking here equation 1. That is equation 1 is root 2x plus root 3y is equal to 0. Root 2x plus root 3y is equal to 0. So what is root? What is the value of x? Root 8 by root 3. So I am taking this root 2 here into root 8 by root 3 into this is value of x into y plus root 3 y is equal to 0. Okay, so now root 8 into root 8 into root 2 will be root 16. Okay, root 8, the product of this root 2 into root 8 will be root 16 y divided by, okay, so into the root 3 as it is, plus root 3 y is equal to 0. Okay, root 2 into root 8 will be root 16 divided by root 3 plus root 3 y is equal to 0. Okay, root 16 is the square of 4, so outside it will become 4 y by root 3 plus root 3 y is equal to 0. Okay, so we can multiply by this root 3 here and here. Okay, so what is going to remain? 4y plus root 3 into root 3 will be root 3 into root 3, 3y is equal to root 3 will move here, or now we can write like this also. 4y as it is, root 3 into root 3, 3y is equal to 0. Finally we will multiply by this root 3 into 0, it will be right, RHS will be 0. So 4y plus 3y is equal to root 3 into 0 will be 0. 4y plus 3y will be 7y is equal to 0. So y is equal to 0 divided by 7 is what? 0. 0 divided by 7 is 0. Okay, so this is the value of what? Now we will put y is equal to 0 in the equation. In equation we can use this first second one. Okay, or you can write here also. If you want the value of x is equal to in equation x is equal to root 8 upon root 3 into 1. Okay, so x is equal to root 8 upon root 3 into value of y is 0. So x is equal to this product will be 0. So value of x is also 0. Okay, so method is same. Substitution method we have taken any one equation we can use for the substitution. Here we have taken second equation, root 3x minus root 8y is equal to 0. Minus root 8y we move that side, that is plus root 8y. So x is equal to root 8y upon root 3. Okay, so this value we need to put in the first equation. So root 2 into x is plus root 3y is equal to 0, as it is equation we have taken, or directly by substitution, by putting here value, this equation we can use here. So root 2 into x is root 8 by root 3 into
into y plus root 3 into y is equal to 0. So root 8 into root 2 will be root 16y upon root 3 plus root 3y as it is. Root 16 means 4y, root 3 plus root 3y is equal to 0. Root 3 into root 3 will be 3y divided by root 3. Root 3 will multiply here. So 4y plus 3y will be 7y and is equal to 0. Y is equal to 0. Put this value in x is equal to root 8 upon root 3 into y. So y is 0, means this whole product will be 0. So x and y both are 0. Okay? So I think we have understood what is substitution method.